In this video, I'm going to teach you two strategies you can practice today to stop caring about what others think. If you pay close attention to the things you care about, you will discover that they are the things you value the most. Let's say on a Friday night, you have the possibility of hanging out with your friends or to go out with a girl you feel so-so about. It's very likely that you will go out with your friends because you will have a better time with them. But what if you had the possibility of hanging out with the girl of your dreams? It's very likely that you will excuse yourself with your friends and go out with that girl. In the first scenario, you valued your friends more than the girl. In the second scenario, you value the girl more than your friends. What this means is that you are the one who decides what you will value and in what order. So, what does this have to do with not caring about what others think about you? See, you care a lot about the opinions of others because you haven't decided what things are truly important to you. Instead, you rely on what society defines as important to determine your self-worth. With that said, let's talk about the first strategy to stop caring about what others think, and it's to define your values. Values are simply the degree of importance you give to some actions or things with the aim of determining what actions are best to do. For example, if you're someone who values courage, then you will probably take risks. Even if people doubt you or discourage you from taking risks, if you are aware that courage is something that matters to you, the opinions of others will be irrelevant. If you value loyalty and honesty, then it will be easier to stop hanging out with deceiving people. No matter if other people think you're being silly, if you're clear about what you value, then your actions will follow and you won't care about the opinion of others. Having clear values will allow you to base most of your actions and beliefs on your perception of things. Even though the opinions of others or advice might be useful, they will not dictate how you will feel or act because your values are guiding lights for your behavior. By the way, let me suggest you watch this video on how to build unstoppable confidence. I think it's a great complement to the strategies mentioned in this video. I will leave the link in the description. With that said, the first strategy alone might not be enough because we're tribal creatures and we will always take the opinions of others into account, but the issue is to what extent. In addition, the media is constantly bombarding us with what success looks like and thus what we should value. Things like being rich, being in love, and being beautiful are things that as a society we tend to value. That's why we need another strategy to stop caring about what others think. The second strategy is to rely on internal validation instead of external validation. Most people rely on external things to feel good about themselves. This is when you need other people to think highly of yourself so you can feel happy with yourself. This can look different across people. For instance, people can rely on social media likes and compliments to feel good internally, or they can also buy stuff to impress others. While external validation feels good in the moment, and we all need it from time to time, it's a terrible long-term strategy because its effects disappear very rapidly. For example, while those 100 likes on your latest Instagram post feel awesome, that feeling is very limited. The problem with external validation is that it requires you to care a lot about what other people think about you. That's why I suggest you rely instead on internal validation. This is when you develop internal metrics for what you consider successful and judge yourself according to this. The beauty of this is that success looks very different from person to person, and that's why it's very useful to define it for yourself. Let's say that for you, success is being a self-published author who earns just enough money to travel the world. This will make it super easy to ignore every person who wants to disqualify what you're doing. Or, let's say that for you, success is being healthy and in shape. This will make it super easy to stop caring about the opinion of people who want you to drink every single weekend with them. The key with internal validation is that you must define what quote-unquote success looks like to you and judge yourself according to that. In the end, you can't avoid judging yourself, but at least you get to choose how you will do it, so make sure to choose your own metrics instead of society's. Most of the time, people go along and accept what others think about them because they are afraid of being rejected. For that reason, make sure to watch this video if you don't know how to deal with rejection. Just click right here.